This is Inside Train World with Model Power, MRC, and Mantua.
So what's new and exciting?
So we're very excited for this Prodigy Wi-Fi, MRC Prodigy Wi-Fi, okay? And this will work with any Prodigy system. So all you do is simply plug it into the cab jack. Currently, if you were to, before buying this, you were to use a smart app. I have an Apple phone here. And Wi-Throttle is the app that we'll work with this unit. You would have to plug in, set up a wireless network with your phone, your home network, plug into your computer, use JMRI, plug into your DCC system, mm-hmm. and then go to your trains. A lot of steps. A lot can go wrong with your home network. In fact, when I spoke to the owner of Engine Driver for Android and the owner of Wi-Throttle for Apple, they said the number one complaint that they got, the number one customer service email or phone call that they got was simply somebody's home network was screwed up. He says if it's 100 things, 100 emails come in, 99 are going to be because somebody can't figure out their home network. So we said, okay, MRC prides itself on making easy systems. How do we incorporate that into bringing smartphone capabilities to our systems? Well, the MRC Prodigy Wi-Fi. So you plug it into cab jack, you search like you would for a home network, it will broadcast its own network. So we'll plug this into a Prodigy system, and MRC Prodigy Wi-Fi will come up in your choice of Wi-Fi networks. Select it, open up the app, you're in, you're done. That's it. There is no other configurations. There is no other setup of home network. You've bypassed everything else. Computer's gone. You're using your Prodigy system. You're going Prodigy box here. That's it. You've gotten rid of JMRI. It gives you up to 8 handhelds. Okay. Now it doesn't take over.
What do you mean? Eight trains you can control.
You can run 8 phones.
Eight phones.
Smart devices off of one Prodigy Wi-Fi. So basically,
for a club, it's good.
If you're in a club or in your basement, and you got a Prodigy Advanced Sport in your basement, you got one throttle control, a real handheld. That's still going to be the boss. That's still the master. You can do all your CV program. You can do your address program. You can do your routes, your turnouts, all that other stuff. You go, and I'm with this phone, an Apple. You download Wi-Throttle Lite. It's free. We're not charging you. Okay?
What's it called again?
Wi-Throttle.
Wi-Throttle. MRC?
No. Wi-Throttle is a separate company. It's its own. We are making our system capable of working with anybody that has an app out there.
Gotcha.
That will work with us. We're kind of being open source. We're not forcing you to buy a proprietary app mm-hmm. or software. What we're saying is, okay, here's an established throttle control app out on the market that's been on the market for a while. We'll make our system work with it. But we'll bypass all the hard stuff of a home computer network and a home JMRI, which there's nothing wrong with JMRI.
Plug and play.
Yeah, it's a plug and play. Exactly. The key word is plug and play. The key term is plug and play. So with this, you'll be able to do some consisting, not advanced consisting. You'll be able to do turnouts and accessories.
On your phone?
On your phone. You can do custom function labeling. So instead of having F1, F2, F3, F4, light, bell, horn, whatever you want, you can make up a name. You can call it
you can enter.
Kenny's horn.
Right.
Whatever you want it to be. Mm-hmm. Of course,
can I order takeout?
You can't order takeout. Now, one of the things that we have, one of the great features about this, a lot of that's all stored here. So if you are, we're at your basement.
It's pretty light. Is there anything in there?
Right? That's another thing. So we made it mountable and it's so you're gonna get 90 feet of range. So you're in a basement and you got your Prodigy system. Somebody comes over, you have no more throttles, they want to run trains, you want to do an operating session. Mm-hmm. You got a smartphone? You got an Android or an Apple? Download this app, done. Mm-hmm. Okay. Once they're in, you can have all your trains on your layout already set with custom function labels, yep. The names of them, the roster's all set, and because everything is stored here, that person's going to pull up his phone, he's going to see that all on his phone already. They didn't do anything. Mm-hmm. It's all set up for him. The CVs, everything. Everything is already done. Because he did it with his throttle control, or, yes, I didn't mention this point, this will work with JMRI. You will bypass the computer and you will bypass the router. So this essentially would replace the router. Mm-hmm. Okay? So we made it so that JMRI could run through this as well.
Okay.
Now,
So this app...
this app is already available.
Okay.
It's been on the market. People use it.
People can control any manufacturer or certain manufacturers?
So all DCC decoders will work, and any train will work with us. Mm-hmm. The only system it works with is Prodigy. That is the exclusivity.
Okay.
It is Prodigy Systems, Prodigy Wi-Fi. Can't work with Digitrax, can't work with NCE.
So if a guy's got multiple train systems on their layout, once you get your Prodigy system, this will work all those systems?
All the systems. Mm-hmm. All the systems.
Okay. So yours is the system they should have on the layout, and then they could also have others if they want, but...
And so now we're basically giving you, for the price of a handheld, a throttle, we're going to give you... Anybody with a smartphone can come in. And what the great part is, it also is a limitation on operation, so that, you know, 8 people don't need to have CV programming. 8 people don't need to have, you know, kind of be the yard master, if you will. Operate, call up the addresses, run the functions, run the trains. There you go.
It's great at shows.
It's good at shows. And again, it works with Android as well. And it's got $119.90, I think, put down on here.
$120.
$120. Let me just see. I think it should be in here now. It's numerical. Look at that.
Numerical?
Yeah, $119.98. So it will be available actually. So it's going to be programmed and tested in the U.S. So it's going to be available starting. We hope to have it next week, but it'll probably be, I'll say, earlier February.
Next week?
Yeah, it's arriving. Okay. This is a factory sample.
Mm-hmm. We didn't even take pre-orders or anything.
We wanted to be sure that it was ready. Okay. So that's the other thing. We wanted to make sure that we were ready to go, and we worked out all the bugs. There wasn't a lot of bugs.
Is this a limited production first time around where we have to order very heavy?
We brought in what we thought was appropriate. But we have, obviously, it is made overseas, so that factory disappears for a little bit and then comes back on. But we believe we have enough for the next couple of months.
Okay.
But we've gotten a lot of good reviews for it. It's not...
Do you have the train app on your phone?
Yeah, I'm ready to roll.
Okay.
I'm ready to roll.
Can I just see what the
yeah.
curious...
So this
because I've never been to that, use that app.
So this is the Wi-Fi.
And it's Wi-Fi train?
Because nothing is coming up, the Wi-Fi is not plugged in.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
But use no server, okay? So here's the throttle, okay? It's very simplified, but it would be your functions. I can custom label them, okay? Mm-hmm. There's a camera. Now, I'll come back to Wi-Fi throttle in a second.
Reverse. Camera?
A flashlight. You'd be surprised how many people
like that.
Yeah. Addresses. Right now, I was playing around with the accessory feature yesterday, so I only have accessories. But you get the recent list, which you can delete any one of them, and then you can have your consists, and then you can have your whole roster put in here. Settings. Now, this, I'm going to show you the cool feature when we get plugged into a system, because I can't right now. I need to be able to do it. But, right-handed, left-handed, okay? One of the other things that is also good, if you're doing yard work. So you have mainline stuff and then yard work. So pro and reverse, the throttle can be set up differently, so it's easier rather than having to hit that.
Right.
So you even have dual mode. You can run two locos at once.
Huh.
Okay?
Now, how does... So this, by plugging in this box, it will detect which trains are on and throw it to the iPhone?
So this is going to plug into a Prodigy base.
Right.
Either the Elite,
right.
The Advanced, or the Express.
Right.
How much is the Express retail?
That's $149. Yep. Okay. So you would plug this in. The phone would talk to this just like it's a throttle controller, hand controller. And tell the base unit what to do. Like you're operating it, just like a DCC system.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it's not detecting it doesn't pull up a list of trains. This is actually your MRC control.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. You will be able to, when it's plugged in, if you have 10 locomotives on the layout, you'll go in and with already established addresses, which you set with the old throttle.
Right.
Okay. You can then, in turn, store their addresses, their functions, their whatever CV things, whatever is there, will be stored on here, so that if you pull up the locomotive, you'll see the exact settings. You'll have them already. You won't have to change anything. It'll be just like you had it programmed on the decoder. So, but you'll see it on your screen.
Okay.
And again, we love the custom function label. I know it sounds simple, but again, you don't have to remember as much.
Yeah.
So, one of the other things I want to be able to show you, which again, I want to get plugged in. So I talked about the customization functions. We can sit in here, we can put in network passwords, user passwords. Again, you'll see the back end when we get outside and I show you on the layout. What this does, and one of the things, and when people thought about this, we were going back and forth. Once you're connected to MRC Wi-Fi, it does disconnect you from the internet. And the reason being is, when we sat and we spoke to people, you are operating trains. You are operating on my layout. I don't need you on the web. I don't need you reading emails. I don't need you. You want to do that? Go connect to another Wi-Fi network. This keeps you embedded and immersed in the operating of the trains. It keeps you in the hobby. So it's been pretty good. We have a default. I know this is a little technical. So all MRC throttles have a default cab of 1. That's their address of the throttle. This is default cab of 2. You can change the cab number. So if you have multiple 1s, cab 2, cab 3, cab 4, whatever, you can change that out. We also have a foolproof, what I call foolproof, nothing is foolproof, reset. So let's just say you set a network password on this. You're an older gentleman. You're a younger guy. You just forgot. I don't know what the heck it is. We have a reset button, but it's not as simple as just somebody walking up, going like that. You actually have to go into the settings, and it prompts you. Hold down button, press this button at the same time. So it's kind of like you can't do it by accident,
right. But
then it resets everything in terms of the password and lets everybody back in. So we thought about a lot of things, and I'd like to show it to you.
Okay.
That's it.
We'll definitely go take
amazing
a look at
how
it.
The technology is changing in trains and keep moving forward.
As long as it's easy to do.
And that's the main thing.
When
you see how fast this disconnects, it's a no-brainer. It's literally one extra step than plugging in your regular cab jack. It's that simple. And you know, if we made it complex and we started adding in all the advanced features, it becomes not so simple. Yeah. And we want this for the younger kid, for people that just want to operate and run trains. And again, if they want to do the advanced stuff, use your throttle control, or yes, go use JMRI.
Will that work, Lionel?
Anything DCC. Anything DCC on a Prodigy system. Okay.
More for HO and...
HO and...
Even
you can run
G.
Run G. But if they have DCC, it will work.
Right.
And that's it.
All right.
So that sounds good.
And congratulations.
Thank you.
For raising the bar again, for sure. And now everybody's got to follow you.
Yeah, we're excited for it. It's gonna be really good and expand the abilities of the Prodigy system.
I want to talk about the N-scale engine.
Okay, I have two here if you want to take those.
Yeah,
the green boxes. I brought 4.4 on a 2.6.0. So the biggest improvement on these, besides having the DCC and sound, was, you know, every generation of locomotives that we've put out on the N-gauge team, we've aimed to make them better each time. We listen to the customer base, and the tender pin, axle pin pickups on the trucks was new. That required new tooling. We got rid of the wiper pickups that were on the axles. People had a lot of problems with them. They got dirty. This is the best you can do on the tender pickup. We've added a little extra weight to the tender.
Yeah.
Just so that gives a little balance to the locomotive, a little more capability.
Very nice.
They all come factory equipped with traction tires. We only ran these once under model power.
Right. We blew them right out.
Now they have the traction tires. In your hand, the 440. We could not do this on the Mogo, but we actually have a pony pickup. There's actually an electrical pickup on the front truck, which wasn't there. LEDs. We've improved the wipers on the drivers. And then both front and rear operating knuckle couplers. They're the Bachmann EZBs.
So it's almost a re-engineered engine. Yep. It looks fantastic. It really,
5-pole Mashima motor.
Very nice.
And the DCC and sound, that's basically as small as you can get.
Yeah. It's definitely hobby looking. It doesn't look like a toy at all. It's very impressive. Very impressive.
We just did a video on these, and I took a look at it running, and totally night and day between the old run and the new run.
Spent a lot of time.
I think the biggest, I guess roadblock for us as a manufacturer, as a dealer, you guys as a manufacturer, is probably just letting people know that it's a big difference between the old and, you did a lot of updates on this. It ran smooth, very smooth.
Well, we actually, this was supposed to come out in June.
Oh yeah,
I got in 24 locos. And start over. We actually
that's because you're a train guy. You need train guys that work for companies.
Yeah,
once you have non-train guys, it's not good.
I didn't like the sound of the motor.
Yeah, very
good. I didn't like the gearing.
These boxes too.
Yeah, we change up the boxing, the packaging, and there's a distinguished one between DCC and sound and sound. You'll see black is for DCC and sound. You have a different color green on it.
Yeah.
But we added some new road names that we never had. I got more prototypical in terms of, even more so than the first run, paint schemes, and we even got into classifications on some locomotives where we could. The one thing we didn't do, we didn't run a Vandy tender this time around. Just the quantity and it was cost prohibitive for this engine. So your SP doesn't have a Vandy. We do offer, which can be available to you guys as well, a upgrade kit for the tender, but I don't recommend it for anybody. It's available because the market demanded it. It's limited to what we have, but it is available to you guys to sell. But it is not an easy feat. Mm-hmm. I would not recommend it unless you're an expert modeler.
Okay.
I expect the people that use this engine, most of them are.
Yep.
The guys that will buy this, they know what they're doing. But if you don't know what you're doing, don't do it.
Yep. Okay.
The only thing maybe on the future is the item numbers. Instead of just adding a one, just make it a different number. It gets confusing.
This has been we tried to stay within the themes of the item numbers. That's why also we did that. So it's tough. It's tough. We did the same thing with Mantua.
Yeah.
Sometimes
it just gets confusing, and it's, I don't know. It's, I get, sticking it, but it's a, just sometimes it's just easier for a whole different number.
Yeah, or the pulp pickers and stuff.
You miss one number, they miss
it. Yeah.
Even adding it online, you miss one number. It's a long thing.
If people don't remember, so, this engine, not only is it the metal boiler, you got metal cylinders.
There's a metal stamping.
There's a lot of die cast in this engine.
Oh, it looks great.
That
sure.
Is not normally there. And you know what's good? This engine in particular.
It can have a lot of road names too.
Yeah. A lot of road names, and it's small, so it can operate on a lot of layouts. There's not everybody has the big layout.
Well, it also works with small tight radius.
Tight radiuses, and that was really, this engine is unique in that regard.
I like your instructions. It breaks down the engine for parts. If anybody breaks anything, know exactly what they're talking about.
We have the parts. Mm-hmm.
Is DCC and sound outselling the DCC ready?
Three to one.
It's very, especially on this.
I'm getting to the point where
bring?
Do I even bring in non-DCC? But there are people still that guys, don't have it.
But they can still run it.
Yeah. But even then, it's $100 more. Do I want to pay it?
And these are dual mode decoders, right?
Yes.
That's good.
Obviously, it runs a lot better on DCC and stuff. Okay, so we have a Prodigy Advanced Squared system hooked up here. Obviously, it comes with the Elite handheld. So this will give you, of course, all your CV programming, your address programming, routes, con system, all the features you can get out of a Prodigy system. But as we come into the 21st century, we are proud to introduce Prodigy Wi-Fi, MRC Prodigy Wi-Fi. Right. So you can use all your smartphones, either an Android device or a Apple device. So what I'm simply going to do, and watch how simple this is to get plug and play, to operate into a cab jack. We'll go in here.
Got to get through the fence here.
Got to get through the fence. Okay, so this little device, it's red, so it's on. Right now it's broadcasting a Wi-Fi network, MRC Prodigy Wi-Fi network. So I'm going to take out my little iPhone here, big iPhone. And actually, I'm already coming logged in, but I would go into settings, and it shows me a list of all the Wi-Fi networks out there. Well, there's MRC Wi-Fi.
Okay.
So you would select it, which it's already done. You exit out of your settings. I am using Y-Throttle. It is a separate company. It's an app already out on the market. I've downloaded it. I've taken the pay app. There's a light version for free, or for $10 more, you get the advanced one, which gives you dual throttles. You get some consisting, and you can do turnouts and lighted accessories. So this will work with any DCC locomotive, but you must use a Prodigy system. So let me open up my throttle.
That's all we had to do, is just plug that in.
Plug that in. I'm done. I'm already connected.
All right.
All right. There's a... This locomotive is a Mantua 060 saddle tank switcher.
Yeah, good quality engine.
Default address is 3. So I'm going to call up 3. 3 is already in the keypad.
Yep.
Set. Turns green. You go back to the throttle. And we're off and running.
That's easy. That's very easy.
You hear the bell. So one of the great features of this DCC system, this app, is we can sit here and, there it goes, it's crawling along now. Is the light on? Let me turn the light on. So the light's on.
Yeah.
You can see the light's on. One of the beauties of this is custom function labeling. In the back end of this software, which is operating out of the MRC Wi-Fi, Prodigy Wi-Fi module, we can do custom function labeling. We can also set some consisting. We can do, as I said, the turnouts and the accessories. But anything I store on here, if I am the owner of this Prodigy Advanced, so this is the Trainland Prodigy Advanced Square, and this is your Prodigy Wi-Fi. Anything you set on your layout with its addresses and its function labeling, everything will be stored. So if anybody else pulls up a handheld and downloads the app and they take out their smartphone and they want to operate these trains, they will see the same labeling and naming that you've done already on their phone. They won't have to do anything else.
Okay.
So they already will have a custom function label. So one of the things I'll show you on the back end, it's better to go this way.
Yeah, show the camera.
So we can actually change through Y-throttle, left-handed and right-handed. We have, since I have the advanced featured one, the $10 app, I can actually run two locomotives at once, so you have two throttle controls. And then you also can do yard work. So make it much easier on some, I'll have it go in reverse. Oop. There we go. Changes direction. Now it's backing up. And so on. So it'll come to a stop, it'll go to idle, and then it'll go back forward. So, very easy to use, very easy to set up. But now I actually want to show, let me just stop it. All right. If we go to the settings, on the bottom, and again, you will only see this on Y-Throttle with an MRC system using MRC Prodigy Wi-Fi.
Yep.
You'll click the MRC logo. A browser will come up. In here, you'll be able to change the cab number of the Wi-Fi itself, because every Prodigy system, the throttle control starts at 1, so this has to be assigned cab 2. You can obviously keep adding cabs. Okay. Module settings. In module settings, we can set the cabs, accessory control layout, depending on who it is. Fast clock, you can actually show it or don't show it. You can toggle that. And then you can set up pass keys for people to get in and out and what access they have. Go back. Network settings. This is, again, you can name the network. If you don't like MRC Wi-Fi as your network name, MRC Trainland. You can call it that, give it a Wi-Fi password, just like you would a home network.
Okay.
And this way you can also keep people in and out of it. If you're at a show, if whatever it may be, whoever you don't want access to have. And you can leave it wide open. You don't have to touch that. Roster. Okay, so this is really cool. This is where I think is the best part of it. So you can do default functions. Just F1, F2, F3, all the way on up. But you can also name them. So right now I have light, bell, and horn. I can call it, as I said, Kenny's horn. Mm-hmm. And F2 will become Kenny's horn. So we can change that. Additionally, you add locomotives. You can decide whether you want it to be default functions, no function labels, or your custom function labels. So you have various ways you can control your functions per loco and per address. And you could set it so that maybe this steam engine's at default.
Right.
And then perhaps you got another engine, this G-Scale one, which is not plugged into it. But you can have it all custom, and you can name it whatever you want.
And do you have on your own website a video of operation of this, or going to have?
So it is so new that you guys will be before we actually have a video. That's how new it is.
Okay.
This is not available for another week or two. You guys are actually, TrainWorld is getting the exclusive first video out there.
We're in the middle of January 2017 right now.
So you're, you can erase an entire roster. Accessory controls, again. At the old test track back at MRC, I was playing around with an accessory decoder by MRC. And you can assign different accessories and toggle them on and off. Very easy to manage. Oh, one of the best things. You need help? FAQ, in the phone, on the module, stored. How do I run trains with this? There you go. It's all here.
Directions.
So directions are actually in the app, in the module. It's stored here.
Okay.
So you need help, plug it in, you go, and you can find things out.
Mm-hmm. That's great. That's a great feature. I was looking on the back of this to see, instructions or anything. But
typically MRC does do that.
So on the handheld.
We made it a little bit easier. So now it's actually within the app. And then again, let's just say you screw up, you forgot your password, you don't like it, what's going on with what you got set up. We have a reset button here, hard, but we made it kind of accident-proof as best we could, where you actually have to go reset all settings, and it will prompt you to hold the button and press reset at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
So kind of a safety feature.
Yeah. Yeah.
So you can operate the train, and I can operate train, and we can go back and forth.
And it also works with your wireless system?
Works with the wireless. Wireless will operate just like a wireless handheld.
Okay.
This essentially is expanding, giving you 8 smartphone devices on top of whether you're using a tethered one or one of the Prodigy Wi-Fi, Prodigy wireless hand controllers.
Okay.
So it makes no difference. There's no issues in conflict there. Again, you just you would use the wireless doggle would be hanging out of another cab jack.
So guys like me that technically challenged, I like this, but the guys that can handle anything, and that's really simple, I tell you, I'm amazed that you just plug that in, go onto there, and you're doing the same thing that I'm doing with this.
One of the other things, which we don't have a second phone, if you're on your phone and I'm on my phone, I will actually see the throttle move up and down as you're controlling it. So everybody's on the same page of what they are, speed settings, what functions are on. So we really like this. Again, if you have an Android device, you download Engine Driver already on the Google Play Store. So both of these apps are already available. They're out on the market. They're well known to people that use JMRI, and actually you can, rather than going through your home network, then your computer, then a computer interface to the Prodigy system, and then your phone,
mm-hmm.
you can bypass that all just with this device, but JMRI will work through this.
Okay.
You'll be getting rid of the home network. This establishes your home network.
Mm-hmm.
And the retail is $119.
Mm-hmm.
You're essentially getting 8 throttles.
Mm. And you need the Prodigy system in order to use that.
Yeah, so we'll work with any Prodigy system. We've even had somebody tell us that it works with the original Prodigy Advance.
Okay.
So that hasn't been on the market for about 15 years, maybe longer. Yeah. So it is backwards compatible.
And your Prodigy system is one of the best out there, without a doubt. We sell tons of those, and all the different models in it, the beginner model to the experience wireless model.
Well,
it's simple, it's proven, it's a win-win. What you're doing here is you hit the next level of simple electronics for trains,
and that was the goal. Yeah, thank you.
Yep.
Thank you.
Yeah. What's my discount?
Well, you can get it here at Trainland, so
TrainWorldTV, thanks you very much, and you can buy all your stuff at trainworld.com, shop online. Thank you very much.
So we got you're going to go into Google Play, you're going to type in engine driver, there it is, all right, download it, once it's downloaded, all right, open it up. So actually back out first, go to your network, go to look as if you were looking for a home Wi-Fi network, so where you typically go to find your networks. Okay, so you're gonna look for MRC Wi-Fi. There it is right there. Hit open, connect. Okay, there you are. You connect and go back to that app, the engine driver. Yeah. Oh, there you go. Click that. Okay. No. Just click that, connect. You're already in. Oh, go ahead, type in the engine 3. It actually already shows, see, it even shows my name. Okay, so he's already pulled up my name. So that locomotive and the Wi-Fi module has Adam Tager saved in there as a setting.
Just click on it?
Just click it. Go ahead. You can just, you're running it.
That was fast.
That's it. You're operating the thing.